Let's say a church needs to form a committee of three people to handle outreach to local community centers. And if the church has 10 people from which to choose, how many possible committees are there? Well, the first thing we have to ask ourselves with a question like this is this a permutation or a combination? Does the order matter? And in this case, it doesn't. There's nothing special about any of the positions within the committee. There's nothing special about being chosen first versus chosen third, for example. So this is going to be an example of a combination. Now, if we look at the numbers, we have a group of 10 people. That's the N in the combination formula. And we're forming a group of three people. The church, there we go, of three people. That's the size of the group, which is the R in the combination formula. So if we substitute those numbers into that formula, we get this. The two N's become 10, and the two R's become 3. Then we start simplifying. 10 minus 3 is 7. That 7 cancels with the last 7 numbers in the 10 factorial. That leaves 10 times 9 times 8 over 3 factorial. And if we just, simplify that, do the multiplication, we end up with a total of 120 possible committees that this church could form.